Hare Krishna.
As long as the mind is pure, no place is secure. When we go through life, we always want some security. We want to be safe. When we start practicing spiritual life, at that time also we want safety. We want to protect our devotion from temptations. We don't want to fall down from our moral and spiritual standards. And for that, we may often think that, okay, this place is so materialistic. This place is filled with temptation. This is unsafe. And then we may go to a temple. We may go to some sacred place. Okay, this is so pure. I am safe here. Yes, there are places which are filled with temptation, and the possibility that we may succumb to illusion is maybe greater over there. But we can't presume that just by going to a pure place, we will be secure. Why? Because the real thing which tempts and deludes us is not the external sense object. It is the internal impurity. Krishna tells how self-destructive desire is present within us, in our own mind, senses and intelligence. In 3.40 he says, Indriyani mano buddhir asya adhishtanam uchyate etair vimohayatyesha jnanamavritya dehinam. It says that it is in the senses, the mind and the intelligence that illusion is present, that self-destructive desire is present. And in the previous verse, he reiterated the same point by using a very scary, sobering describer for self-destructive desire. He says, avritam jnanam etena jnanino nitya vairina kama rupena kaunteya dushpurena nalena cha. He says, we are all deluded. Our knowledge, our intelligence is deluded by what? By self-destructive desire. And what is that desire's characteristic? Nitya vairina. It is our eternal enemy. Eternal means in all places and at all times. Life after life, it can trouble us. Even if we go to a temple, there lust, anger, greed may trail us and torment us. So the real solution is purification. And that's why we can try to put ourselves in a safer external situation. But rather than putting too much effort in trying to put ourselves in a safer situation, in today's world, temptation is almost everywhere. So we can, instead of trying in vain to create external safe zones, we can focus our energy much more on purifying ourselves. Although complete purification, by which no impure desire ever rises in our heart, may take a long time, but just by invoking Krishna's presence, by just striving to focus on Krishna, who is all pure, by doing that, we can at least temporarily drive the impurities out of our hearts. So we need to diligently practice bhakti and invoke Krishna's presence in our heart. And we focus our energy not so much on trying to find a safe place externally, but keeping our mind in place, keeping our mind at the lotus feet of our Lord, focusing on Krishna, infusing our consciousness with Krishna consciousness. It is in being conscious of Krishna that we can find the supreme purity and the supreme security. Thank you. Hare Krishna.